Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let's look at converting audio and video files using iTunes. So I'm using iTunes version 11 and I'm going to show you how you can use iTunes to convert music and also video files. So if you look in your music library here and you select a song and you control click on it, you'll see a large contextual list here of commands. One of the things you'll see is something like create and then AAC version or MP3 version. This will create a new version of the file you have selected in that file format. The way you set the file format is you go to iTunes Preferences under General and you look at Import Settings and it's set to AAC. Now let's say I want to convert some music to MP3 files. I change it to MP3, I can further customize the settings. And then when I control click on a file, you'll see that it has create MP3 version. So let's try that. Let's go and create an MP3 version and see what happens. And what will happen here is I'll end up with two versions of the same song. And you can see one was just added and this one is much older. So if I go and select control click on it again and say show in Finder, I'll find this one here as .mp3, and if I select this one and say show in Finder, I'll see that's in a different location here. They may actually be in the same location depending upon how you have your music arranged. So I have my original one and the new version there, and you can see they're slightly different sizes. So I can set to compress more. If this was an AAC song, this would then be an MP3, which could then be very useful if, say, I was, had to transfer them to a CD, an MP3 CD, or use them in on a USB stick on a device that only read MP3 files. Now, in addition to that, if you select a song, you can also go to File and then Create New Version, and you'll have the same command there that you'll see with the contextual menu. Now let's go to Movies, and in here I've got some of my own videos that I've put in here, and I can select one, and also I can go to File. It's not in the contextual menu, but you can go to File and Create New Version, and it gives you two options. Create a version for the small screen iOS devices, iPod and iPhone, or create for the larger devices like the iPad or Apple TV. And either one will not only create a version that's sized to fit those screens, but will also do it in the same type of format that's required by those devices. See, one of the things about all these devices is they only read certain file compression formats. This really helps saves battery and processing power if it doesn't have to know about hundreds or thousands of different types of video formats, but only certain ones that work really well with low-powered mobile devices. So by converting your videos using iTunes, it will also create a second version here. Let's do that here for this one. And then once it's done, I'll have two versions of the same file. I could delete the first or save them both, but only the new one will be compatible with devices like the iPod and iPhone. And then when I go to Sync, I'll just have the option to sync that one, which is all I want. It's just be able to sync that exact one. Now I should also add that for video you can also use QuickTime Player to do the conversion. So I can open up a video here in QuickTime Player. As long as you can open it and play it here, you should be able to export it, and then you'll see the ability to do it for devices, and it'll actually show you the different devices you can export to. And notice how it doesn't even give me this one here. One of the reasons for that is because the video isn't that high enough resolution to need to go to this size. So going here is exactly what I want, and I get some nice information here, like it'll tell me the size before I do the export.